Hey everyone, Shashank this side. I hope you all are doing well today and safe at home. Today we will learn about the concept of TCP three-way handshake. It's an interesting topic to understand, as well as it's important to understand this topic from interview point of view. Because in most of the interview, interviewer asks this question, what are the steps involved in TCP three-way handshake or how the flow happens? So there will be no practical demo today. It's all theoretical, what is happening in background when client send a request to server and what is happening in background with TCP three-way handshake. Let's start. As we know, TCP stands for Transmission Control Protocol, which basically follows a connection-oriented model. And with TCP, data can be delivered successfully and accurately. Nowadays, almost all the applications that we use, whether it is web application or email apps or any other apps, uses this particular mechanism. So before TCP transmits a data, it will use three-way handshake to establish a connection. Let's see what are the steps involved in this diagram. Okay. Before that, I'll start the slideshow. So we have a scenario where we have a client and server, and client is asking a response from a server, or client is trying to get a connection established to a server. So the first step is like client sends a send segment to the server asking for synchronization, which basically means I want to connect with you. So send is synchronization. In short term, I want to connect to the server. So client want to connect to the server. Second step, in response, what will server will be going to give? So in response, obviously, if it is a valid request, server will gonna acknowledge that request. Plus, server will also ask a synchronization with client. So when client is sending a send request, send segment to the server, in response, server will be going to acknowledge that request. Plus, server will also ask, I want to get a established connection with client as well. So that's why we have send plus acknowledgement. Okay. Now, at third step, what client will gonna do? In return, client will reply with acknowledgement, which means, yes, I'm okay or ready to have a connection with you. So above all these three steps confirms that there is a two-way communication established between client and server. Now client can send a request to the server. Let's say it's a web application hosted on server. Server will gonna respond to the client in form of a web page. So that's how the three-way handshake happens with TCP, and this is common across the board. So I hope this clears a lot how the three-way handshake happens when client want to connect to a server. Okay, so I just want to share with you another diagram with a better pictorial view. Let me end the slideshow. Again, the same scenario, we have a client and server. Client is requesting a response from server. In return, server is doing a respond with acknowledgement and asking for a connection from client as well in form of send segment, and in return client is doing an acknowledgement. So how the packet goes while client requests a connection, so that consists of sequence number, acknowledgement and send. Now client is sending a request with a sequence number, let's say 1001. We don't require an acknowledgement while sending a request. We need a send, because the first step to send a request is send, which is synchronization. I want to establish a connection. So that's why the value is 1. Now, while returning, the acknowledgement number will be like the sequence number which was sent by the client plus 1. That's the acknowledgement number will be sent to the client. Okay, that's why we have 1002. With a synchronization, because server is also want to connect with a client, so that's why the synchronization value is 1. But when server is trying to get a connectivity to client as well, the sequence number will be different. It has its own sequence number, right? So that's why we have 2001. Again, these are the random numbers that I have picked just for making understanding a better way. Now, while returning the value from client, since we don't require any synchronization, that's why we have value 0, because the third step is the acknowledgement from client. That's why the acknowledgement number is 2002, which is the sequence number which server has sent plus the value 1. And sequence number will be the same as the acknowledgement number that we have from the server. So that's how the packet sequencing goes when client requests any response from server and server do the same kind of workflow with the client. So that's how the three-way handshake happens. So just an additional update for you guys. I'll be starting up a new networking basics video on my channel as well, parallel with other cloud videos. Just wanted to cover a few important topics on networking, like how load balancer works, workflow happens in general with best practices, what are public and private SSLs, how HTTP, HTTPS workflow for the protocol side happens. So that's an update. And that's it guys for this particular video. I hope you will gonna like it. And if you're facing any issue with any kind of concept understanding, just place out a comment in comment section and I'll be there to help you. Have a nice day. Bye-bye.